In this tutorial, we'll go over how and where JetSet records the takes you shoot and the tracking and VFX metadata that goes along with these. All right, we'll click our hamburger menu and go to the project panel, and the project pick panel shows up, and we can see a list of the projects that are on the device. So if we want to add a new project, we just hit the plus sign, and that'll create a new project. We can select it, and we can hit the edit sign, and then we can edit the project name. We can call this test project. And we can come over here and edit the prefix. And the prefix is a up to 6 character prefix that is appended in front of every file that is created with JetSet. So you can keep track of which files go to which project. So we'll go test project. All right, done. And then we can specify which camera letter we want. It defaults to camera A, but you can enter different camera letters. And here we can see the path. JetSet data is stored in a project folder under the JetSet directory in your iCloud account. You don't need to use iCloud to transfer data to AutoShot. AutoShot has a direct file transfer system over Wi-Fi that we recommend instead. The project name will specify the subfolder that the files will be stored under. And here you can see the full path of where things will be stored. So we'll click OK. And we'll come over here and shoot a quick take. Great. And we'll stop. And then we're going to go into our files application. And we can see that underneath our original iCloud drive and under JetSet, we have created our test project file, and we see that under our project name, JetSet has automatically created a takes subfolder and a model subfolder. And the models are where the models will be stored, and the takes are where the takes will be stored. So we'll go into takes, and you can see our next subdirectory is a dated subdirectory, and every day of shooting goes into its own dated subdirectory with the project prefix. We'll go into that, and we can see the next subdirectory is the camera A, as we specified earlier. And then we can see our tracking metadata and videos subfolders, which is where the actual folders are stored. And later when we sync the files to the Mac or PC running AutoShot, we'll see that this directory structure is preserved, keeping our take data nice and organized. We'll exit out of the files app and back to JetSet. And that wraps it up for JetSet's take storage.